We're asked to write the given division problems symbolically, then compute the results. The first question is, how many times does negative 4 go into 20? If we look at the notes below, notice we have 6 divided by 2 equals 3. Another way to think of this quotient is determining how many 2s are in 6, which is 3, because there are 3 copies of 2 and 6. So the quotient for the question, how many times does negative 4 go into 20? We would have 20 divided by negative 4. And we can write a quotient or division in several ways. Another way is to write it in fraction form, because a fraction bar means division. So we can also write this as 20 over negative 4. In our homework system, we're asked to use the forward slash for division, which means for the quotient we enter 20 forward slash, and then in parentheses, negative 4. And because a positive divided by a negative is negative, 20 divided by negative 4 equals negative 5. I also want to mention, for every division problem, there's always a corresponding multiplication problem. For the division problem 6 divided by 2 equals 3, the corresponding multiplication problem is formed in the reverse order, which is 3 times 2 equals 6. So if we wanted to check our work for this first example, 20 divided by negative 4 equals negative 5, because the corresponding multiplication problem is negative 5 times negative 4, which does equal positive 20. For the next example, we're given the statement negative 27 divided by negative 3. This is written in the way we normally read a division problem. This is negative 27 divided by negative 3, or in fraction form, negative 27 over negative 3. The symbolic expression that we enter is negative 27 divided by negative 3. If we wanted to, we could also include the negative 27 in parentheses. And because we have a negative divided by a negative, negative 27 divided by negative 3 equals positive 9. To check this, negative 27 divided by negative 3 equals positive 9, because the corresponding multiplication problem formed in the opposite direction is 9 times negative 3 equals negative 27, which means 9 copies of negative 3 equals negative 27, which of course is true. Next, how many copies of 3 are in negative 12? We could also read this as how many 3s are in negative 12, which is negative 12 divided by positive 3, or in fraction form, negative 12 over positive 3. We enter negative 12, which can be in parentheses but is not required, divided by positive 3. And again, the positive 3 can also have parentheses if we wanted. Because a negative divided by a positive is negative, negative 12 divided by positive 3 equals negative 4. Looking at the division problem, negative 12 divided by positive 3 equals negative 4 corresponds to the multiplication problem, negative 4 times 3 equals negative 12, which is true. And for the last example, we're asked to write a division problem with a divisor of negative 9 and a dividend of 45. For any division problem or quotient, it's always the dividend divided by the divisor equals the quotient. So because the dividend is 45 and the divisor is negative 9, we have 45 divided by negative 9, and therefore we enter 45 forward slash, and then parentheses, negative 9. And because a positive divided by a negative is negative, 45 divided by negative 9 equals negative 5. Let's also look at the corresponding product. 45 divided by negative 9 equals negative 5 corresponds to the product negative 5 times negative 9 equals 45, which is true. I hope you found this helpful.